It's quite refreshing to know that you can look as awful as possible.
Yeah.
And you're meant to. Is that your natural hair colour?
It's a bit red.
Oh God, it's amazing.
Oh, thank you. I'm orange more than red normally.
That's beautiful.
Oh, thanks. Thanks very much.
I want that colour. I could do that wearing a wig.
It's from a box.
Is it?
Yeah.
Would my hair go that colour?
I think you might have to bleach it first. I know.
Sorry. I'm
sorry.
I'm so sorry.
No, it's fine. I was going to say, this is going to sound really weird. You have the exact same eyes as my mum. So I feel like I have this like uncontrollable need to like ask you to teach me how to iron a fitted sheet or something. Just like
feel
very comforted.
The worst person for that.
Sorry if I get overly familiar. I just feel like I'm with my mum. Well, congratulations on the favourite.
Thank you.
Mum.
That's a little bit weird.
I know, sorry. I've made it too far. There are so many like absurdist moments in this film, but and like wrapped in like a sad character in your one. But I did want to pick up on like some surface level stuff. The makeup in this is incredible.
Nadia Stacey, isn't she a genius?
Yeah. Did you feel like you had to like FaceTime people when you were just wearing this like white caked makeup?
Oh, there's a lot of, photos to my kids. Okay. Have you done your homework?
Was it weird wearing all that, like, essentially just white powder all over your face?
Yeah, really fun, though. It's sort of, it's quite refreshing to know that you can look as awful as possible.
Yeah.
And you're meant to.
Yeah.
And that's fine, because the pressure to try and look nice is much greater and horrid.
Yeah.
So I really enjoyed it.
Yeah.
And Nadia was so brilliant at not doing the sort of prettified version, but doing it as it was.
Yeah.
You know, they weren't very good at blending and, applying.
Contouring.
Yeah, contouring.
I did like that the blusher looked literally like you just had two fingers and like that. Yeah,
exactly. It's brilliant.
It's so good.
And the lips. And there was, you know, those little black moles or little patches they used to put on their faces, which were covering up the holes from lead makeup.
Oh.
Apparently, yeah. But she then took it to an extreme and did a sort of horse and carriages on cheeks and
Nicholas Holt was taking over his face.
Yeah, brilliant.
It was great. Yeah. There's a scene where you and Rachel are in a mud bath.
Yeah.
And the only thing I could think about was it actually mud? Or was it like, it looked like chocolate pudding or something?
No, it was mud. No, it was unfortunately not chocolate pudding. And it got really cold.
It looked like you must have been there for a really long time.
Yeah, and they kept trying to top it up with, because it was so solid. I'd forgotten all this. You get a really hot patch because you couldn't really stir it in. So we were trying to get it round and wiggling our feet to try and warm each other up. And then you get a roasting hot patch. it was really fun.
So how long were you in there for?
I don't know.
A whole day?
A few hours.
Okay.
Maybe not a whole day.
Just caked in mud.
Yeah.
Solidified.
Yeah, you're finding mud for, for days afterwards.
There's also a really good dance scene between you and Emma. It's one of a few dance scenes in this film.
Yeah.
Are any of it, improvised? Because they're kind of strange. So, was it all choreographed or was it?
Yes, all choreographed.
Oh, okay.
Yes. Because they took sort of, the classic period dance that we've all seen and turned it on its head.
Yes.
As well, particularly Rachel and Joe's dance is hilarious.
It gets more absurd the more it went on. This is incredible.
Yeah. It's great, isn't it? Yeah.
Yeah, it was so, so good. Being a royal clearly suits you. I know that it's not going to be the last time you're playing a royal for us.
Yeah.
And again, I said this before because, you remind me of my mum sometimes. So I felt very comforted when I found out that you were going to be in The Crown.
Oh, thanks.
Very, I was like, it's in safe
hands.
It's
all okay.
It's all going to be okay.
Mummy's there.
But the reaction, what have you felt about that announcement and how that's all gone since you announced that you're going to be in The Crown?
I try very hard not to read what people say because I'm not very thick-skinned.
Okay.
And if someone says something, even just a little bit mean, I can't cope with it. So I don't know. Hopefully it's all right.
It's all been very good.
Oh, has it?
Yeah.
Oh, okay. Well, great. Yeah.
But I'm the same. If I see one comment that's she's got weird ears, I'm like, oh, my God,
I know. I know. And what makes people think it's all right to say that about someone they don't know?
I know.
Or no. It's old-fashioned bullying. There's no two ways about it. So.
And this film is getting a lot of buzz, awards buzz. So 2019 is gearing up to be a pretty big year.
Well, we'll see.
Have you booked a holiday to gear up for what will be a hectic 2019, I think?
I'll be filming The Crown, so I can't do anything about it.
Oh, this is like a bit of a distraction then.
Yes, that's quite nice. I can pretend. Yeah. It's normal. Just going to work.
Just going to work. Thank you so much and congratulations
very
on
welcome.
The favourite.
And
thank
I
you.
Bet your mum's lovely.